Okay.
Yes, sir, I have started, sir.
Okay, thanks. Okay, welcome to all people and good morning to all for the last session of this module 3 from my side. In the module 3, we started with the introduction of machine learning. Then from we moved to various concepts which include different types of learning and different five school thought of understanding machine learning. Then further on different learning like a supervised and unsupervised learning. In supervised, we have seen at least three algorithms which include a regression, binary logistic regression, and Bayesian. And we have taken a multiple use case and multiple problem to solve through R also. And sometimes you have seen how to do a graph in Excel also. Then further we move to we move to unsupervised problem. In unsupervised problem, we have seen two things, broadly PCA and cluster analysis. Again, we have taken a different types of data set and different types of application, and we just made a demonstration through R. So that is what we see. Then next we move to basics of time series, that is day before yesterday, which cover the key components of time series, especially trending, seasonality, and random. Further, we move to what is a very basic understanding on time series, like what we can call as a differencing, stationary, non-stationary, then returns, simple returns, and the logarithm returns. So these are the things we have seen, right? And as a part of your syllabus, this is what the syllabus is mentioned. And we have been giving as much as theory and as much as R also. Because as per the university syllabus, there is no practicality and they never insisted us to use any kind of software. But as we know the matter of fact, okay, when we are getting into job or when you are looking for some employability through data analytics things, then obviously you should know some kind of very well-known software like R or Python. So that made us to started with the R, and we are just keep on progressing. And meanwhile, we have seen as much as theory before we start any kind of practical work. But only thing is, I am not saying that this is a 2 mark, this is a 3 mark, or this is a 5 mark, or this is a 10 mark questions. Because myself, I am not involved in this university activities. My predominant job is teaching and training. So I may not help you in this, how to figure out which question will come, what question should think. And one more thing is, I believe that you guys are like an adult, okay, studying PG and seen a lot of examination all over your period of your education experience, and you know better than me. So end of the class, what I'll do, I will share the PPT and I'll share the code part of R also. And any doubt, you are always, you can come back and you can ask me, okay? Okay, and now let me jump into neural network. The neural network is a very big subject. All this time, what we are seeing is a kind of a machine learning, okay? But neural network itself is a separate subject, which comes under what we can call as a deep learning or a deep neural network. The most of your artificial intelligence, the applications of artificial intelligence, such as when you say what all the intelligence are there, we know that human beings known for biological intelligence, but machine may not have the biological intelligence. But machine, what machine trying to mimic the human being, then we can call as a machine intelligence. Now the name became artificial intelligence. And this is not something new, even way back, maybe in before Second World War, or during Second World War also. We know the scientist's name called Alan Turing, who is considered the father of computer or other things. So he made how machine can able to understand things. So from that we got Alan Turing, Turing concept also, or Turing machine also. So these are the foundation for that. And then across across the various field, people try to imitate the human being with help of machines. That is how artificial intelligence boomed. But the current scenario is very much, we can say, it is an era of artificial intelligence. The reason here is, earlier we don't have the enough algorithm to understand how this artificial intelligence has to work. And we don't have enough storing process. And we don't have enough memory capacity. Thus, there was a time, okay, when we have to carry the file with the help of floppy disk. So floppy disk, I don't know, most of people may not seen the floppy disk. It is just, it looked like a 2.4 MB only. So we can store only 2.4 MB at a time. So for that itself, we felt it's a great job. Then later on, we got a memory system or a external hardware like USB, which can cover something like, when you heard about it, can cover a 20 MB, we just opened our mouth. Our eyebrows are raised also. But now we can see that with a small USB, you can have even terabit or petabit data also. So that kind of memory process, hardware support, and algorithm, this all developed over the period of time. That made artificial intelligence quite popular. But for artificial intelligence, the fundas come from, rather than a machine learning, it has come from a neural network, or what we can call as a deep network. If you go back to the very old slides, what we have seen in the previous session of classes. For instance, I'm just going back to the slides. Okay, so these slides we started at the very beginning of the class. If you see the slides, okay, now why I'm taking these slides? The reason is there is a logic behind that. So initially people felt, okay, data mining is a great job, which is predominantly covering the business applications, okay, but using the machine learning algorithm internally. Then we got a separate subject or separate discipline called machine learning, okay, which is a subset of AI techniques, and it is trying to go for predicting the data based on probably two algorithms, that is called two learning curve. But later, the field moved to, from here, it is moving towards a neural network. So neural network is artificial, NN, otherwise we can call artificial neural network, area about a subset of ML techniques, and loosely inspired by biological neural network. So this is a key important word. So where they got inspiration? They got inspiration from a biological neural network. They're usually described as a collection of connected units and called artificial neurons, organized in a layers. So each term is very important here. First term is biological neural network. So when you say biological neural network, like we are human being, and we know how our brain systems are working. We have a lot of neurons, and one neuron is passing information to other neurons with help of dendrites, with help of axon, and this is how it's working. Right, and we have a conjunction boxes like a synapse. So this is how the neuron works. So the scientists taken the inspiration from the biological brain structure, and they're trying to imitate for the machine. That is how we got a concept called neural network. Okay, so we'll see what is this neural network, at least in a very basic level, to understand the intuitive concept behind the neural network. So then extension of neural network, what we can call as deep learning. A deep learning is a subset of NN that makes a computation, a multi-layer NN feasible. So when you say multi-layer, what is multi-layer? I'll show a lot of different diagrams. For instance, they mentioned DNN, CNN, RNN, DAN. So when you say DNN, it's a deep neural network, convolutional deep neural network, and a recurrent neural network, and a generative adversary network. So like that, we can say we have at least a close to 80-90 NNs are there, or I mean to say neural networks are there. But what today we are going to see is, what is neural network, and what is the basic function of neural network? What is the application of neural network? What is the pros and cons of neural network? Then how we have to do neural network to our program. So this is how I structure this class today. Now, as we know that, okay, so when you see this one, this is also very early stage of our session we covered. The machine learning is five school of thought, right? So
So in the five school of thought, when you say, what is this five school of thought? So some is symbolist, then connectionist, evolutionary, and then Bayesian, then what we can call it analogous. But when you say the neural network is a combination of, from you can say, broadly from two areas. What are these two areas? If you just see the two areas, one is what we can call as connectionist, right? Connectionist is important for us. And second thing, what we can call as evolutionaries. So these two things is a foundation for what we can call as neural network based things. When you say connectionist, the origin of the tribe, when you say tribe, their school of thought is a neuroscience. The group of relates back proportion, back propagation to solve problem. Then evolutionaries is the origin of this tribe is evolutionary biology. These groups replace on genetic programming and solve the problem. So these two things are a foundation for what we can call as neural network. Okay. So I'm trying to connect the dots what I kept in the earlier session. So one thing is we understand that that what is the difference between data mining, machine learning, neural network. So earlier we have seen all those things, but you may not able to connect very properly because we didn't come across what is machine learning also. I just introduced a terminology. But now what I'm trying to do means I'm trying to make you to recapitulate what we have covered and what I'm going to cover. There is some big connections out there. And how to understand this connection in terms of intuitively and through R code and through some of the application. That is the objective of the today's session. And you can see in these things what we mentioned. The artificial intelligence, a machine mimicking man's skills, which includes mechanical, analytical, intuitive, and empathetical. And whatever, these all the skills going to be mimicked by machine. See, for a man, certain things are very easy because it's inbuilt in his biological process. A man can identify it by object, by seeing whether the object is dog or cat, whether the person is male or female. That is not a big thing for a man because inherently we got that skill or we got that what we call sensing activities. Our mind can able to figure out that. So we never taken that is so complicated because it is by default we have. So that nothing great in that. That is what we understood. But when scientists trying to mimic the same skill, identifying the when that scientist trying to mimic the human being, make the machine to identify the object is dog or cat. Okay, then that is not simple job. That is a bit complicated in terms of how to connect this. Okay, now when we are listening to some of the politician voice, we can able to recognize. Okay, this is a voice of CM. This is a voice of PM. We can able find out because we got the inherited sensing power for us. But machine cannot do that because after all, machine is a machine. But the challenge here is how machine has to do this. How a scientist made machine to do that. That is all about these subjects. That is what we can call as deep learning, which includes various network, what we call neural nets. And what we are going to see today is just like a, what is the foundation of a neural net, right? Okay, so I hope this is clear for you. So here we have seen two connections, connectivation and the evolution, which has come from a school of thought, which is foundation for machine learning. Okay. So now in these things, if you see that, okay, we already seen, okay, this this is mathematically, we already seen, right? Some extent this is mathematically. What we can call as and ML part, slightly we already seen what is ML part. Okay, now if you say DL wrapper libraries, when you say DL, it's a deep learning, DL things. These are the things we could not see because for that we need some more packages and some more things. And one thing I understood, the kind of the group you guys. So you guys are more exam-oriented guys than a practical application-oriented guys. Okay, so if I am aware of that, you are very much a practical guy, then I might also prefer very much for how to use a TensorFlow, how to use a PyTorch, this all we might have seen, but as of now, you guys, your area of interest not in practicality. It is more about how to pass the examination. So what are the stuff we are giving is more sufficient for? So let me go back to the things on what we can call as. Okay, so neural network, other name is ANN, artificial neural network, information processing, a model inspired by the biological neuron system. So when it's information processing model, okay, what is the meaning of this information processing model, right? So that we should understand. So when you say information processing, normally any kind of information, so how it is going to process? Okay. So any kind of information you see here. So any kind of information, when you say information processing, we need some input, right? And some process and some output, right? This is normally how it works for any kind of information processing, right? So that is what we're trying to say there. So input leads to a process and process leads to what we can call as output. So this is what we can call as information processing model. So how the information is processing? So we have some set of input. From the process, we'll get some output. But this is inspired by biological neuron system. So when you say biological neuron system, as we know that, okay, the human brain has got millions of neurons. And how then each neuron going to connect with another neuron? And how it is going to, information going to pass it? And how there is some kind of stimulus getting from a electrical or a chemical information process. The information process can be triggered with the help of two ways. One is what we can call as a electrical process, or other one what we can call as a chemical changes happening in the body. Okay, so that is what we can call as the first sentence is AN is in information processing model inspired by biological neuron system. It composed of large number of highly interconnected processing element known as neuron to solve problem, because we know the human brain has got many millions of neurons. So what I am showing here is input process output is such a simple example. So when you say input, you have multiple input, okay, maybe 10-20, and you have process, you have 10-20 process, and you have output, you have 10-20 output. So it is look like a completely like a zigzag kind of going information from one level to other level. All right. So this is what we call. Okay, then it follows a non-linear path and process information in parallel throughout the nodes. So we know what is linear information, right? So linear information is when something X is increasing for one unit, it'll make to increase your Y for one unit. If X is going to decrease one unit, Y will also decrease one unit. That is what we can call as linear relationship. But here, what we clearly mentioned about, it's a non-linear path. So non-linear path is if you are giving you one input for a input, that will make you to jump your output for a 10 or 20 also. So not necessarily proportionally it will increase 1 to 2 or 2 to 3. It may exponentially can jump from 1 to 10 or 10 to 100. It has got the ability of doing that. That is how our mind also works. So in a very natural way, if you see that, the scientists mimic the neurological system. And they got inspired from that and they developed the information processing model. And in that model, information will start from input and move to process and go to output in a parallel way and in a very multiple way also. So that is what this first paragraph speaks about, right? Okay, now what about the second paragraph speaks about here? A neural network is a complex adaptive system. What is this adaptive system? So when you know adaptive system, we are trying to know something is happening in the environment and we learned out of that and we change our behavior. That is what we can call as adaptive system. Now, as we know that Darwin, Charles Darwin, the author of Origin of Species, who challenged the theory of church and come out with that the world is not created by God. World is his own way of understanding our creation. That is what we can call as nature of selection. Now, in the nature of selection, okay, he used one word, survive the fittest. What is the meaning of survive the fittest? Okay, we know that there was a time. Okay, we studied from the history, we studied from the geological aspects. There was, we can say, different types of dinosaurs were lived in the earth. But over a period of time, dinosaurs is completely extinct. The reason here is dinosaurs could not learn how to survive. It could not change its behavior. It could not change its the physical level to adapt for the current scenario or adapt for at that time whatever the scenario comes. So a lot of species is extinct because of non-adaptability. But you can see the human being has got a wonderful behavior of keep on adapting. I mean to say keep on learning, keep on changing as per the requirement. For instance, okay, 3 months before we are having a very normal life. But last 3 months, because of a COVID attack, a lot of changes happened in the society. And now human beings know how to adapt it also. And we already adapted and we keep on moving for next level. So this is what we call as adaptation. So when you say adaptation, based on the scenario, based on the environment, we are trying to change ourselves and keep on going for further. So a neural network is a complex adaptive system. It is not just like that very what we can call as a very constant system. It is keep on changes because of environmental keep on changes. A neural network is a set of connected input-output units in which each connection has a weight. Okay. So when you say weight, it is almost look like a beta in your regression analysis. So this connection, input-output connection, create a weight because this weight will say which is important, which is not important. And the neuron, the network learns by adjusting the weights to predict the correct class label of the given input. So here a little bit of algorithm come to picture. So what is the correct class label? Okay, now we have seen different types of data. For instance, in a Titanic data, we have seen a person will survive or person will die. And there is some kind of defaulted data, whether person will pay the money or not. So this is what we can call as a class label, right? So after by giving the input, okay, various input, the machine himself able to identify whether the person is belongs to male or female, or the given object is an animal, is a dog or cat, that we can able to find out. That is what we can call. So it will keep on adjust the weight, okay, and able to correct, able to predict the class model. That is the given attributes or given class label is whether A or B or S or no, or dog or cat or male or female, that can able to predict. So that is the beauty of this thing. So key word from this slide, what we can call, because these are the theoretical parts from the germination point of view. That is why I'm just trying to explain to you, because I don't want you to just by heart like a kid and going and vomiting on the paper. Once you understand the key word, you are in the position to explain to you. So one of the keywords is neural network is inspired by biological mechanism, and it is an information processing model, and it just tried to solve a non-linear problem also, non-linear problem. Okay? And it has got a habit of, it's a very complex adaptive system. So when you say adaptive system means it is learning from the environment and keep on changing as per the environment. And neural network is, it has got a lot of connection as an input and output. This input and output provided a weight. And weight is keep on changing as per the requirement, and it can able to predict whether the given class is A or B or C. So in that way, this is really, this neural network is a great job. Then AN is listening to problem, or often referred to as a pattern recognition. So that is what we explained, right? When you say pattern recognition, can you able to see whether the person is male or female, or whether the particular pet animal is a dog or cat, or whether you're able to understand whose voice is this, whether voice is a male voice or female voice, or whether the voice is belongs to US president or Indian president. So in that way, this all are great job, right? And we recently we are listening from various sources that Twitter has got a problem because more than you can say, at least 10% of people are tweeting. They are not people at all. They are machines actually. And they're generating a lot of news for us. And that news also false news. And they're creating the fake news, and the false videos and false images and the morphing images and different voices mixing. So there are so many things are happening. This all came because of invention of what we can call as a artificial AI, that is called artificial neural network. So every technology or every new invention has got its own plus and minus. Invention itself may not have any kind of negativity, but anything depends on how they're using invention. Okay, how people handle the invention in their hand, whether for positive purpose or negative purpose, that makes the invention or the technology the progress in coming days, or it will be disappear from the world also. Okay, so this is the basic slides. So from these slides, you can able to understand or you can able to write what is neural network, what is the features of neural network, what is the advantage of neural network, right? So let me move to next slide. Okay, next slide is more about what we spoke about information processing, or the inspiration come from biological neural mechanism. So you can see this, there is here, this is all the complete neuron structure, a kind of neuron structure. There is a concept called dendrites, nucleus, axon, synapses, right? So the interconnected web of neuron known as biological neural network transmit information through electrical signal, or it may be through chemical signal. Okay. This parallel interactive systems makes brain to think and process information. Now, dendrites of a neuron receive input signal from another neuron. So you can see this slide. So like this, there are one more things will be there. So that receive the information from, the dendrites receive information from other neuron, right? That is what we are trying to get here. And respond output based on inputs to an axon or some other neuron. So this will pass information to axon. Based on those inputs, the fire on output signal via axon. So there is information is passing through and it is axon activated. The dendrites receive a signal from, and cell body sums all these input signal to generate output, right? So all these signals become an output. Axon through output when the sum reaches to threshold level. So there is a one kind of a threshold level to convert your input into output, right? A synapses is a point, it is a point of interaction neurons. So it is connecting one neuron to other neurons, like what we can call as conjunction, okay? It transmits electrical or chemical signals to other neurons. So that is the job of synapses. So dendrites receive the information from other neuron and it start giving a signal via axon, and axon produces output, and synapses is a kind of a conjunction which is connecting one neuron to other neuron. So this is how our what we can call as a brain mechanism works, right? So now we try to connect with what we can call as the machine neural network. So if you see this two diagram very carefully, okay. So in this diagram, there is a set of input you can see. In this diagram, you can see set of input, right? Okay, so what is this input meant for us? Let me take. So this all my input actually, right? These all are input, like input in the sense x1, x2, x3 variable, right? And we have some set of output also, you can see. So then this is what I call as information processing model. So there is set of input and set of output. Here we are given only one output, but you can have a multiple set also. And there is something called activation function, which is quite important. Okay. And what we can call as, this is what we can call as a weight. So this weight, the input converting into weight. Okay. After this weight are attained one threshold level. Okay. And during this information process, we'll get a noise also.
As we are aware of that, in any information process, we have two things. What are the two things are there? So one is what we can call as signals plus noise, right? So this is how any kind of information processing will work. Any information processing model works, right? Any information processing model works. So in this case, this is all the input, and the input converting into weight, and further it is moving to the, it has got some kind of bias also. And all put together what we can call as activation. So when you say activation function, what is the activation function normally doing? So activation function shows the relationship between input and output in a very simple language. So if you take, what does this activation do for us? So activation, okay, so this activation, activation does a function between input and output. Okay, that is what called activation. So this is a very simple, what we can call as a neural network diagram. Okay. So let's clear all the diagram. So in these things, you can say Y. Y stand for output variable equal to summation of weight into input. So weight into input means this combination, right? There is a, some kind of product is happening here, plus your bias. Okay, and this all what we can call as X, this all what we can call as Y. The X and Y, there is some kind of relationship or function is happening, that what we can call as activation function. So if you read this, you can easily understand. Here X1, X2 are input variables. W1, W2 are a respective weight variable. And B is the bias, which is summed with the weighted inputs to form the net input. Right? Bias and weights are both adjustable parameters of the neuron. So when you say both are adjustable parameter, what is the meaning for the adjustable parameter? In the previous slides, we have seen something called neuron is a complex adaptive, means it has the ability to change its internal structure by adjusting the weights and inputs. So this weights, you can say the parameters, that is called both your what we can call as both your bias and weights, will keep on change because the system is learning from the environment. The system is learning from the past data and it is trying to adjust the learning rules also. The output of neuron can range between positive infinity or negative infinity. It can go anything. And actually neuron does not know boundaries. So we have to fix the boundaries. Where is that it has to be stopped actually. Okay, this mechanism of mapping of inputs to output is known as activation function. So this is what we can call as, and there is a relationship between your input and output is known as a activation function in neural network theory. And there are two types of information processing. If you see that information can go from two ways, right? So one is we can call as information can typically information can go from like this, right? This is what we can call as a forward feed forward. So it's only go one direction, it never comes back. So I can give information from X to Z, X to Y, Y to Z. That's it. Then it never comes from Z to Y or Y to Z. It never comes back. This is one way of understanding how information flow is happening. The other way of information flow is what we can call as feedback neuron. Okay, right? Like a feedback forward, we have a feedback neuron. So feedback neuron, what it does, it will get the information from Y to X, then here also, like this information go. Again, it will take the new information, again it will come back. So that is one kind of cyclical. Okay, this is what we can call a cyclical information. So information process happening in the cyclical way. But when you say information happening only one direction, that is for feed forward. Now, if you see, come across this diagram, finally, we have one more diagram here. So what does this diagram indicate? So these all are input set, these all are output layer, and this is what we can call as hidden layer. So this hidden layer, if I keep only one hidden layer, I can keep many number of hidden layers. Each hidden layer depends upon the complexity of the relationship or the data. So if you keep only one hidden layer, it is almost equivalent to your linear equation, the simple linear equation. So here there are multiple hidden layers between, which is placed between your input and output. So activation function defines the output of neuron in terms of local induced field. Activation functions are single line of code that gives a neural net nonlinearity and expressiveness. So we know that very well that neural network works very well, especially for a non-linear rather than a linear, right? Because most of the problem in the world is not a linear at all. It is based on a non-linear problem. But we are trying to address this non-linear problem with the help of a linear regression. That is the biggest pitfalls in the statistical theory. So now the computing theory or machine learning theory or deep neural network theory, which is proposing a new concept, what we can call as a non-linear relationship. That is what we can call as activation function, which is, says the relation between input and output. That is what we can call as activation function. So these two diagrams, this diagram, and you can see the three slides, easily make you to understand the conceptual understanding about what is neural network, okay, where we got inspiration, how it works, okay. This all the intuitively we can understand in a very high level, right? Okay, then further, okay, now we should understand the activation function is quite important. What are different types of relationship is existing in this activation function? So now we can see something called we have already seen this thing very much in one of our previous slides, and we have seen this one also in one of the previous slides, right? So to go back to your memory, to make your memory refresh the memory, where we have seen this. You can see this, right? So this is what we're calling a linear relationship. This is what we can call as sigmoid relationship. So we know that this is meant for prediction. This is meant for classification. But the beauty of a neural network is it can do both the jobs. It is not like a very tight compartment. I can do only regression or I can do only classification. So a neural network can do not only these two types of function, it can do any kind of functions. So the functions which includes what we mentioned here, key functions. The key functions are 4 to 5. Okay, you can call as an identity function. Identity function is nothing but a linear function, right? A function. So identity function is that maps input to the same output value. So X is increasing one level, Y will also increasing one level. That's it. That is what we can call as a linear function. It is almost like a mirroring the what is X on the Y. Okay. So that is called identity function. But we know that apart from that, we have binary step function, okay, which includes your binary sigmoid or bipolar sigmoid also. So when you say binary sigmoid, it is either 0 to 1. This is what we can call 0 to 1, you can see. So these all are in this place more 0, in this place it is a 1. So this look like exponentially it is increasing, okay? Otherwise, what we can call as it is a non-linear curve. And there is one more sigmoid function, is what we can call as bipolar function. It is also a logistic function where the output varies range -1 to +1. So in these things, you can see they stop with a 0 and 1. But if it is going below that, that become -1 to +1. Okay. So you can see how this look like, right? So this origin is 0 here, but it is going below 0. Okay. Now there is something called ramp function, okay, which is generated from appearance of, I didn't show the ramp in the graph. Okay, it maps the negative inputs to 0 and positive inputs to same output, right? So whatever the negative comes, it makes a 0, and whatever the actual value, it will show us actual value. And RLU function, this function is quite used in the neural network theories. What is this RLU stands for? Rectified linear unit. Okay, so it is nothing but it is a better version of this one. This is a what we know. This is known for a linear. Okay, but this is much better than this. That is why we can call it a rectified linear unit. It is the most used activation function in the world. And output of 0 for negative and values of X. So whatever the output we are getting, it is just going like a, whenever it 0 appear, it whenever the negative appear, it become converted as 0. And other things, what are the maximum value to take it. So you can see this both look alike, right? Both look alike. Only thing is this RLU function is a much better function than your normal linear function. That is why we can call this as a
rectified linear unit. Okay, so I hope this is clear as of now to you. Okay, now going back to this things, okay. I'll share one more thing for you. Okay, I'm just sharing one more thing to you. So I come out of my PPT, I'm just sharing one more. See, we know that neural network is a big job. It is not like a simple one. And the neural network itself itself a big subject as of now. Okay, and keep on growing day by day. Now you can see these are the legends, which make you to understand what all these things. Something called backfed input cell. So okay, let me in the color, what the color indicating for us. All the yellow ones are input cell, okay? All the red one are output cell, right? And all the green ones are what we can call as a layer. Okay, it may be simply we will call as a hidden layer, but there are different types of layer. Hidden cell, probability hidden cell, or a spiking hidden cell. But in a normal way, you can understand all the green ones are hidden layer. And all the blue ones, what we can call as, it is about the memory cell. Okay, how much memory it can process from the input to output. Okay, like how human brains are working. Because without memory, the neurons won't work. Right? That is what we can call as a blue one. Then all the pink one, what we can call as a kernel or convolution of pool. Okay, now to speak very frankly, okay, I just studied one of the very basic neural network. Okay, I may not aware of what all the very complicated or very advanced level of neural network. Maybe in another 1 or 2 months time, I might be able to catch up this. Okay. As of now, I may not position to explain all these things, but just for your awareness, I am just showing what all different types of a neural network is available. Okay. So what we have seen is this basic, like feed forward. So when you say feed forward, the information going from only one direction, that is what we can call as a feed forward direction, right? And you can see autoencoder, there are various denoising, sparse. This all technology itself on its own. Okay, we need some more time to make you to understand what is autoencoder, what is sparse matrix, what is denoising, then in terms of statistics, Markov chain analysis, okay. There are various things, right? Okay, so something you can see now, green dominate very much. Okay, where are the green dominate very much? The complex models are happening. Okay. And this is how this. So with the help of this kind of models, a machine can mimic the human being in all level of skills. That is what this neural network is about. I just want to show you, that's all, nothing else. Okay, so coming back to neural network theories. So we have seen here only one diagram, but there are many diagrams. That is why I just showed you, right? So we have seen the activation function also. The next job is, okay, what is the pros and cons of neural network? Please understand, I made this 4 to 5 slides keeping examination point of view, okay? Keeping your understanding on the subject. I guess it doesn't look like a more code or more practical. I kept as simple as, because in examination, they'll ask what is advantage, disadvantage of neural network, right? And what are the application of neural network? Then they'll ask what are the different activation function of neural network and explain the structure of neural network. So on this, keeping this thought in my mind, I prepared the slides, okay? So if you're able to read again, and you'll be able to appreciate what is happening here. So in terms of pros and cons, that is called merits and demerits. Neural networks are more flexible, can be used with both regression and classification problem. That we have already seen, right? So regression problem means only for prediction we can use a regression. For identifying the class label, we'll use a classification. So the two things are different, different school of thought, different way of understanding the data analysis. Okay, but neural network can do both the jobs. It can do both regression-oriented job also and the classification job also. That is one of the greatest advantage of neural network. Neural networks are good for non-linear data set. Okay, so this we know that most of the times the real problem, the world problems are non-linear. But we are trying to overfit or like a linear model for the non-linear data. Okay, neural network can go very well with a non-linear data set with a large number of input such as images, okay? Especially images, because images is what we can call as, okay, it is not only with images, even videos also we can see. So when you say images, it is a static point, right? It does not have any kind of a dynamic movement. But when you say videos and when you say audios, and when you say things, this all like a very dynamic movement, right? Okay, dynamic in his own way. So it is not only for images, even for videos and audios also. It can take a large number of input, maybe 1,000, 10,000, it can able to convert into meaningful way. And neural networks can work with any number of input and layers. That is what we have seen, right? Neural networks have the numerical system that can perform jobs in parallel. Okay, when you say I have a multiple input and multiple process, multiple output, okay, it does not like you are a regression. Okay, what regression will do? If you have multiple x-axis, it will always take x1 with y and keeping other x's as a constant, right? That is how regression works. But in neural network, it is not like that. Parallelly, all the processing will happen. So that is one of the fantastic thing with the neural network. And besides the neural network, okay, there are other algorithms also there, like SVM, decision tree, regression, that are very simple, fast, so easy to train, and provide better performance sometimes. The concern with neural network is it will take its own time. Even if you try taking the hidden layer of 5 or 6 or 10, it takes its own time to get the output, right? But not necessary, neural network always perform better than SVM or decision tree or regression. Sometimes this algorithm can also perform much better than your neural network, right? So before neural network come to picture, SVM dominating the scientists world like anything. SVM stand for support vector machine, which is working for higher dimension level of understanding or the model. But once neural network come to picture, the role of SVM has become very, very negligent. So it has completely taken the neural network started dominating the whole data analytical field itself. Okay, and neural networks are much more of black box. Okay, require more time for development, more time for computation power. So when you say computation power, even for to develop a small model, to deploy the small model, it need a more computation power. Okay, so when you say computation power, there are two things. One is cost also involved in that. In costs of in terms of time. Cost in terms of effort. This is all involved in neural network. So for a simple model, we won't use neural network at all. When the model is so complicated, like identifying the image, identifying the voices, recognizing the voices, and for all these things, we can use a neural network. So obviously, complexity will increase in terms of computation power, in terms of processing power, and in terms of memory, in terms of time and effort also. Right? Okay. So NN can be used only with the numerical input. Yeah, that's one disadvantage with NN. NN cannot work with the categorical data. It has to work only with the numerical data. Even if you have a class label, you have to convert the class labels into a numeric. And non-missing value data, okay, it won't work with a non-missing value. So we have to fill the missing values before we start the neural network. It won't work for a non-missing values. So these are all the limitations or these are the cons of neural network, right? A well-known neural network researcher said, okay, neural network is the second best way to solve any problem. Any problem given in hands, that's the second best way to solve any problem. But the first way is, the best way is actually to understand the problem itself. So the researcher said very clearly, the second best way to solve any problem is apply the neural network. But the first issue is you should understand the problem first. So So what author indirectly trying to say means, if you are not understand the problem in the first instant, don't try to apply the neural network just blindly. So to apply the neural network as a important, the most priority is you have to understand the problem very first. So that is what this phrase is indicating for us, right? So going to NN, what are the different applications of NN make us? Okay, when you say NN, as we know that NN is which is meant for pattern recognition, anomaly detection, time series prediction, and natural language processing. See, this pattern recognition, which includes what we can call as facial recognition, by seeing the face, okay, whether the person is so and so or not, you can able to recognize. And object detection, okay, whether this particular object is, what kind of object it is. Is it a human or animal or it is some other things. And the fingerprint recognition, signature identification. And like this, many things you can do with help of neural network, that is what we can call as pattern recognition. Then anomaly detection. Okay, so when you say anomaly detection, the unusual patterns. Okay, so what is the unusual patterns? Okay, now let us say that across millions of human body, some of the virus are very unusual, or some of the pathogens are unusual. Okay, or some of the things are unusual. Yeah, then these unusuals can be modeled with help of what we can call as anomaly detection models, which is a subset of our NN. Okay, and a time series prediction. So we already aware of what is time series. Just predicting the sales or stock price or weather forecasting or demand production systems. We are trying to predict or forecast for the future period. So this we can. Though we are done with a normal statistics method, like what we can call as ARIMA, ARMA, or GARTS, or ARCH model. But all this statistical model has got its own limitation, and your accuracy may not be so great. So to overcome this problem, okay, we are using a neural network to predict the sales or a stock price or weather forecasting in much better way, right? So that is also one more application of time series. Using NN, you can make a time series prediction. Then the very most important thing, what we can call as NLP. Okay, so NLP stands for natural language processing, right? So what is this natural language processing? It is about identifying the text command, okay, speech tagging, speech recognition, spelling checking, okay, and creating our own word cloud, okay, creating the sentiment analysis, whether positive or negative, okay, and especially to work very well with your unstructured data. When I say unstructured data, like text data, or some people are tagging, okay, some people likes, dislike, and some voice recorded data. So this, what we can call as NLP, can play a vital role. And NLP itself is a separate subject. It's a big subject, where anybody can do a great research on this area. Right? So these are the different application of what we can call as NN. Okay. So I just given the bullet points. Maybe if you refer some of the material and you can able to start enlarge this point, and you can able to produce your examination, and you can able to get good marks also. Okay. So if you see these 4 or 5 slides, I deliberately kept from exam point of view. So one, it says that application of NN, merits and demerits of NN, and different functions of NN or activation of NN, and what is the structure of NN, okay, and what is the relation between human brain and the NN, okay, and what is the foundation, what is the basics of NN. So I just kept these 5 things deliberately to make you to understand and produce your exam. And please refer, I refer 3-4 websites. One of the key websites I refer is datacamp.com community website. Okay. So most of things I have taken, I can say I borrowed from these websites only. So if you have time, you can go through that things also. Okay. So now, as of now, I just completed my theoretical aspects of NN. Now, let me take a few more minutes to finish my practical NN with help of what we can call as with help of R. Right?
Okay. So any doubt in this? Because here theories are very important. Any doubt as of whatever you've seen? Could have adjusted income. Okay. Okay, if you have no doubt, then I can go for our demonstration. Okay. Okay, on this neural network, I referred this particular website. It's quite useful. And you can also get benefit out of this, okay? Besides this, okay, the library for neural network in R is NeuralNet. That is a library, okay? And we are going to see the kind of what we can data set. Okay, this is my data set look like. Let me explain what is the data. We have seen this data set earlier. You can see MPG and cylinder displacement, horsepower, weight, acceleration, and year of purchase, origin, then the name of the vehicle, right? So here, what we, in these things, in this data set, what we're trying to do is, this is my output variable. MPG is output variable. Remaining all the variables are input variables, right? So except this variable, the output variable, these all the things are input variable. So now we are trying to understand that how all these variables can influence on MPG. That is the major purpose of this, right? Okay. So I'm using some apply command to get the mean and the standard deviation of data. Okay, if you just see the mean, so you're getting the mean for each variable. And we get a standard deviation for. Okay, so this both speaks about variable wise mean and standard deviation. So MPG, average MPG for a vehicle is close to 23.44, and a standard deviation, one standard deviation is 7.8. Okay, and we should know that before we are doing any kind of data in a neural network, the data need to be scaled. Okay. Now, what is the scale actually? Okay, when you say scale, to make you understand what is the scale, okay, we have to speak about something called normalization process. So, normalization process is converting, okay, what is the meaning of that? Converting normal data, converting raw data into Z score, or what we can call as min max score. So Z score and min max score, it is like a normalized data. So raw data may be go for big figures. When you're converting in Z score, okay, the scores are ranged minus 3 to plus 3 most of the time. And when you say min-max, the score is ranged between 0 to 1. So this all what we can call as normalization process. So we can't use the raw data in the analysis. For instance, here the function what we can call a scale. Okay, a scale which shows mean of and standard deviation of, right? So we already taken the mean and standard deviation, which has come from here. You can see that is why we computed the mean and standard deviation from here, right? So if I run this command, okay. Now let us see how the data look like. Now you can see this. This is how data look like, right? The actual data looks like this way. If you see the actual data, okay. So now this is your actual data. Let me show you actual data first. Then the scaled data, right? Then you can be able to understand. So if you see this, this is the actual data is 18, right? Here actual data 18 become minus 0.69, right? So 15 become 1.83. Okay, so you can see this is your actual data and this is scale data. This is the actual cylinder, this is scaled. This is actual displacement, this is scaled displacement. So, okay, we are removing the units of each deviation. You can do Z score or scale, both are same. Z score, scale, both are same actually. When you say min max, the min max is makes 0 to 1. What are the output we are getting? It becomes 0 to 1 only. It won't go be negative. But in a Z score, it will become a negative also. So this all data normalization process. For any data analysis, we'll do it. Now we are converting data into test data and what we can call as trained data. That is the purpose of this one, right? So now we make a formula. The formula says MPG is my dependent variable. Tilt. So tilt, I'll take all other variables. Okay. That is what we can call as tilt. So now it has done actually. Now if you see this here, let me keep hidden as a 1. Okay. So you can see linear output, how it look like, right? So this is a function to run a neural network in R. What is the function? The function called neural net. What does F stand for? A dependent variable plus all the independent variable. We are storing as a F, right? And that is what we can call F here. Supervised learning model. Okay. By and large, it comes under supervised learning. So when you say hidden layer 1, just keeping a very less complex type of model, and we are trying to do it, right? So once you run this. Okay, see that because I kept hidden 1, it run very quickly. If you keep hidden equal to 3, 4, 5, it will take a lot of time. So deliberately I kept a 1. This 1 is almost equal to a linear regression, right? So now let us see the plot, how the plot look like. Then from that we can be able to figure out how the models look like. Get the plot. Okay, now you can see this plot, how it looks like. Okay, so it takes all the variables together. You can see this. Okay, this is what we can call as all input variable, right? Okay, this is all your input variable, and this is what we can call as your weight actually. And what you are getting output is output variable. So you can see in this input variable, there are things are given here. Okay, so the most important thing you can see, some are negative, some are positive. Okay, and this is not directly impacting this. This is going to create some kind of a signal and some kind of bias, and further it will go. Okay, that is how it is working, right? So here a very important thing for us, you can see the error level. What is the error level here? The error level is 33.46. So lower the error level, better the model. Okay, that is how it works, right? So now what we do now? If I'm going to make it this one as a
in the place of hidden layer one, if I'm going to make two, so no doubt the error now that is 3,400. Make a hidden as a two. Let me clear this. Okay, now you can see the diagram how it looked like. Earlier the error was 33, now the error was 30.5. And earlier we have only one hidden layer, only one hidden layer. Now we have a two hidden layer. So each layer, each input variable interact with each hidden layer. That is why this crisscross is happening. Are you getting the point? That's why crisscross is happening. So one thing we understood that when hidden layer is only one, you got error called 33. When hidden layer is 3, when hidden layer is 2, you got error of just, you can say it is coming down. So the more the hidden layers are keeping, so more the error can be controlled. But the concern here is, it is easy to interpret your regression. But that is not as simple as to interpret this diagram because it comes under neural network information. So it is as analogy to a human brain. Okay, someone take a decision. Okay, assume that, okay, whether the last by spinner or everyone expect the face bowler going to put out everyone expect that brought a spinner actually. So that is a bit of surprise for everyone. And fortunately or by luck or by great bowling, the spinner, the team can able to win the match. Okay, if someone asks a captain, what made you decide in a last moment spinner rather than a face bowler, then captain says, yes, it has happened just like that. Okay, sometimes he may not be in the position to explain how it is happening because this is all very, very tacit knowledge. It is not what we can call as very implicit behavior. It is very, very latent. We don't know how to express it. In a similar way, okay, when you're doing a lot of okay, I shouldn't explain how this is working. Okay. Now, if I take a three layer, let us assume that, so you noted down three, second hidden layer is a 30, and let me go by third layer, right? But you can see for every layer, time will also change. Time will also make more. You can see now, it takes its own time. See, can you see that? Earlier, it has come very fast when you are doing a one layer, two layer. But for third layer, it takes its own time. So this is what we can call as computation speed. And data is not very big data, it's very small data. But in real time, if you have 1 lakh or 1 million data, like a mini input, mini output, and many layers, then you can't run very fast. It will take its own time. So now you can see that what is improvement is happening. So improvement is happening is, okay, the same input, same output, the layer is only three layer limited, right? It became a three layer. Now you can see the error level. The error level become 26. So it is a drastic, it has come down, right? So from 33, it has come down to 26. Okay. And steps has increased. So this is what is the logic behind the what we can call as hidden layers. I hope this is clear for you. Okay. If I want to know what is this net contains, let me run this, what the net contains. So it shows, okay, weights for each one. And it shows what we can call as it is taking the information from each person and it's trying to figure out what is it, right? Each variable, this is all a lot of stats computations happen here. Okay. So this is what about the how we have to make the model, how you did it. But next go to prediction. So for prediction, we know the same logic, predict, and here instead of predict, we'll say compute. And we have taken net, the net come from here, right? And test data we have, because for a training, we use a train data. For predicting, we are using the test data, right? So run this, it done, right? So let us see what is this predict. Okay, how the predict look like, right? So what I'll do now, so I will take a test data or data.frame. Okay, test
data, comma, predict dollar net ID. So now you can see here the neuron result, how it is, right? So, okay, you can see this is all the data, which comes from data. This is all your data, right? MPGs were actual data. MPGs were actual data. And, okay, now it comes the acceleration, neuron V1, a neuron cylinder. For everything, it takes a neuron, right? What is that neuron? For everyone, it takes. Okay, what is the value from the neural network? Wait, you can see. Okay, and this is the net result, right? Can you see this? This is the net result, right? Okay, now what we'll do that? Okay, here we can go this way also, dollar. I can take only net result. So that will give me a very simple understanding rather than too much complication on the output. So you can see this is what it shows, right? Okay, what is my net result? That is called predicted net result, right? Predicted net result. So this is my predicted net result. And this is the actual one. This is the actual one, right? So if someone is trying to figure the correlation between the two things, what we can call as core of, okay, test data dollar MPG, comma, okay, you can say predict dollar. Okay, now let me store only this predict dollar because I want to find out what in this we can take off. So you can say PR, right? Okay, if I say what PRE contains again. So PRE contains only the score of every person, right? So now I can easily say in this place, okay, I can say PRE, right? So this will give a correlation score for. You can see what is the correlation score I'm getting? I'm getting 0.88. Okay, if I take the R square of this, right? So how do you take the R square of this? Okay, now take power of 2, right? So 78%. So what we are trying to do is we have made the model. All this variable, if you see all this cylinder displacement, horsepower, weight, acceleration, all this variable can influence MPG for 78%. That is what is my R square with a hidden layer of 3 layers. Okay, if I do with the 2 layers, this figure may not be same. Okay, we have to see whether we get the same figure or not. For your quick understanding, what I'll do now, let me keep a 1 layer. So I'll run this in layer. Okay, let us see what is R square I'm getting. Okay, it is more or less close, same, 0.78. Okay, then let me take a layer 2. Okay, you can see this going down, right? Slightly going down for layer 2. Okay, for layer 3 look like a much better than a layer 2. This is how we are getting down. So I hope you can be able to understand the role of hidden layer and how to compute and how to predict and how to compare the predict score with the actual score. Okay. So now the other way of doing, you can bother about, you can see same I'm taking net score right here. This is what I'm doing. I'm trying to find out the error level. Right? So what is the error level for this one? So error level for net is, if I run this, it is 0.26, right? You can see that is what more or less we are getting here, 0.26. Now if you take the error level of same thing, if I'm taking error for what we can call as regression, ordinary regression, you can see R square is how much? 0.69, right? So when we do through neural network, we get R square of 0.78. See, 0.78 means almost 9% higher than your regression model. And if you want to find out the error level, so error level for LM is 0.28. The error level for a thing is 0.26. So still in error level, neural network looks like a much better level. And in R square also, neural network looks like much better than your regression. So either way, we can see that, either way, it's looking like that. Okay, what we can call as neural network outperform the regression analysis. Okay, and if you see that, if you take the neural network of one, it is almost equivalent to hidden layer of one. It may be almost equivalent to your what we can call as a regression model. Okay, now let us see. We know this is a 0.28 something, right? So what is a neural network here? 0.23. No, still it is, even if you keep one layer also, still neural network do much better job than your regression. So this is about a neural network if your given variables are prediction score or a continuous score. But as we are aware of that, neural network will work for either any way of data set. Not only the score data, even for classification data can work. For instance, here you can see, let me take one more data set called PAN. Okay. The PAN data, this is how PAN. Okay, you can see this is a PAN data look like. Age, job, marital status, education, default, balance, housing, loan, contact, day, month, duration, and the why. Why stand for, again, whether default or non-default. So we are trying to predict here whether the person is will take or not take our service, right? Why? That is a thing, okay? And remaining all these variables are what we can call as X variable, input variable, and Y is the output. This time Y is not a continuous, Y is categorical. But still, we can apply neural network because we know that is advantage of neural network. And this time what we are doing here, we are doing min-max normalization. So when you say min-max normalization, there is a formula for that. So we no need to bother. But what I'll do now, so I'll make you to understand. Now after this min-max, how data looks. You can see how the data look like now. Can you see this? We converted this data, right? It was earlier some different data. Now we converted, right? And age also we made a converter. You can see this. This is almost everything range between 0 to 1. Okay? And here also we converted 0 to 1. Okay? So that is how you can take what are the variables we converted here. One is bank balance, 0 to 1. The another one is age, 0 to 1. Then another one is previous experience, 0 to 1, and another one is bank campaign, 0 to 1. So this is the numerical data we converted as a 0 to 1. That is one of the normalization method. Earlier we did a scaling method, Z-score. Now we are doing a min-max normalization. So all the variable become, all the data series become between 0 to 1, right? So then some kind of, we are changing the level of data that you don't need to bother. And this is my model now. So my model says, take all the variables and go for a matrix model, right? Okay. Now, we know the formula here. The formula goes with neural network. F is the input and output variable combined together, what we can call as this F, right? Okay, here you can see that the hidden layer I deliberately is only one, and data is bank matrix, threshold is 0.01, learning rate is there. Learning rate means keep on adjusting as per the things, that is called learning rate. Okay. So let me run this command. So it depends on data, number of variables, it takes its own time also. So it executed. Now we keep something called plot equal to n mod, right? So now we can see how this looks like. Okay. We take each variable, okay? It will take each variable like age, job mix, blue collar, white collar, entrepreneurs, housemate, job management. This is all job oriented, marital signal, that's it, married or single, education, then default yes or no. Then all put together, what is your yes for the product or not? Because it's a hidden layer is only one. So it's almost look like your regression analysis. So this is all your input variable, this is your output variable, and this is your what we can call as a hidden layer, only one, right? That's up by default. Okay. So this is how it looks like. Now, what we can do here, same thing we are doing for a file level. You can see hidden layer, I've just put a C file. But what I'll do, then it becomes too much of things. So I'll just put three, otherwise it become too cluttered. We can't be able to figure out at all. Because all this take is all time to execute. When you work in your system, yes, my system has got a 16 GB RAM, so it is quickly doing. But in your system, if you're trying to do that, sometime it will make a, sometime it will get a hang also. Okay, so this is how it looks like, so cluttered, so mess. But this is how things. So I reduced from 15 to 3 actually. If we kept a 15, what will happen? You can't see the number of cluttered also, number of hidden layer also. So this is how we do, right? Okay. So this I'm saying this about I'm using something like you can see an R prop here, right? What is this R prop algorithm? So by default you are using a resilient back propagation algorithm that is called shortly called R prop. This requires a learning rate limit and learning rate factor. That is why we have given a learning rate here. Can you see that learning rate is null, learning rate is factor also. Learning rate factor will go by minus 5 to 3 plus 1.2. Because in one of the PPT we mentioned that neuron does not know what is a lower limit for limit. We should mention what is a lower limit and upper limit. Right? Sorry, just a minute. So the limit sets the upper bound and the learning rate could reach. That's what we can call as a upper bound and the rate factor is a multiplier. The rate is minus. Okay, if it is a minus, we will go to the local minima, negative value. Plus, we will go to upper direction. Okay, R prop is a fast algorithm, does not require much tuning as other algorithm. Static learning rate, instead learning rate is factor. Because we are saying we won't say learning rate is 0.5. We kept a factor like minus 5 to 1.2. So keep on verifying that, right? So this is how this is working, right? Now coming to your, what we can call as a prediction. Okay, so what we are trying to predict here? We are trying to predict whether it was variable or not. Okay, so in these things, what we'll do now for a predictor table, you can set pred equal to okay output dollar net, right? Okay, so in these things, if you take a table command, put table of ERED. Okay, you can see these are the predictor score, right? 0808. Okay, so we can able to. I don't know why all these codes look like that. So then we can convert into 0.5 or for probabilities for what we need for a logistic regression. Then we can go by what we can call as we can go by table command. Right? Because of table command here. So what I'll do, let me run one iteration. I don't have clue why it is changed. Okay, so we need some more understanding on this area. So let me skip this because I'm not so comfortable on this area. Okay, so this is for when you have two outcome variable, right? Class variable. But you can do same thing for more than two class level also. This is one of the example for that. How to do it for more than two class level. Right? So we have taken an iris data, right? So this is a model matrix. We have three levels. So it is not a two level, we have three level, multi-class model. Right, and this is a computation for what we can call as neural networking, right? So run this and you can make a plot out of this plot of NN score multi, right? See, okay, sometime back, okay, maybe 7 years before, I want to use all this technique. Unfortunately, I can't use all this technique. The reason here is I don't have software. I'm not aware of R. So I have to go only by SPSS or a very costly software. So most of people could not learn this this kind of technique because they can't access a software. But now fortunately, like we shall thank to R and Python, which provide all free things for us. Okay? And it's providing a lot of material to understand this also. So now let us see how this is different. You can see normally Y become only Y, one Y, but in this case, there are three levels out there. So we are getting three levels, and this is a three input I have taken. Petal length, petal length, petal width. And this is, and we have only one hidden layer, right? So this is how it works for, and you can see error is how much, 25 point or something. It's very small data. Now, if you increase what we can call as the, by default, I didn't say what is that hidden layer. So by default, you take only the one as hidden layer. If you mention the hidden layer as a two or three, then it will give a different output for us, right? And this is the purpose to compute means predict. Predict the multinomial things here. Okay. So I can take RS dollar net result. So this is a score for each three, Setoso, Verisicolor and Virginica. So what is the Setoso, Verisicolor and Virginica? These all are different species. So based on the leaf, are we able to classify the species is given here? Can see. So this is nothing but Setoso, this is nothing but Versicolor and Virginica. So these are the score for each one. Okay, so that is how it's predicted, right? So we have seen various models. One is actual prediction, other one is a two-way classification, this is a three-way classification. But if you want to show that what we can call as hidden, okay, let me take this one. So I can take the same algorithm also, okay. Let me take only this hidden. Hidden will make a three. So in this algorithm, where we are getting this. Okay, you can see this. You can see hidden equal to three, right?
By default, it is a 1v1. Or let me take two. Does it take more time to complete? So let me run once again. Okay, now you can see there is change in the error also got changed. Earlier 2.5, now it is becoming 2.2. And you can see there are two hidden layers out there. And there is three classification and three independent layers. So this will work parallelly. That's the reason why the arrow marks are going here and there. It works parallelly. So this is the what I call a quick network from theory perspective, from practical oriented perspective, also using R. Okay, so I am done for the session. If you have any doubt, I'm glad to clarify. Chira, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yeah, you can any doubt on what we covered today? So today coverage, let me summarize what we covered today also, so everyone can be able to recall quickly before you are going out of the session. So today we just covered with the introduction about neural network. Okay, what is the neural network? What is the application of that? And in that, it is very important to say it's an information processing model, and it has got something adaptive system. Okay. And it can be able to learn from the environment and keep on change about the weight. It can able to adjust the weight and the learning things from the environment and keep on adapt also, adjusting it, right? And it is inspired from the human neuroscience concept, like a dendrites, nucleus, axon, and synapses. In a similar way, they have an input layer, and they have a hidden layer, and they have a output layer, right? So the very key things about a neural network, we can call a set of input layer, set of hidden layer, and set of output layer. And this layer will give some kind of signal, some kind of noise also. The signals are come from the weights, and the noise coming from the bias. And there is a relationship between the what we can call as input and output. That relationship is what we can call as activation function. This activation function has got a different things. One may be what we can call as function, a simple function, or a sigmoid function like a binary logistic regression, or hypertangent function that look like a bipolar logistic regression, and ReLU stand for it is a restricted rectified linear unit. So we use most of things this one, that is what we understand. Then further, the movement of information, it can go from forward, that is what we can class feedback, feed forward. It can come from feed backward also, so I can get the information from here, again it will cycle it. It keep on goes like that. So one is not recursive, other one is a cyclic information. And in terms of advantages, a neural network can go both regression and coefficient much better way. It can do very good job for non-linear data, and especially the data images, pictures, and data. And neural network can do n number of input, n number of output parallelly, which you can say that it is not easy to explain, and it is not easy to interpret. And one more part is a computation process takes a lot of time in terms of things, and deploying a neural network, even simple algorithm, not easy in the real time. So this all what we can call as the pros and cons of neural network. Then we understand some of the application part, which includes what we can call as where we are using the neural network things. So sometimes, most of the time we are using in a pattern recognition and NLP. So NLP and a pattern recognition played vital role to take the neural network into the next level, we can say some extent. Okay. Then we can able to use neural network for any kind of forecasting, any kind of prediction also. So these are the advantages of neural network, right? Now further, we have seen a lot of R-oriented work, okay, which includes what we can call as so we just went to R, through that we learned so many kind of what we can call as you can see the various diagram what we have done here. These are neural input. So we have seen three different algorithms. One meant for regression algorithm by using the data set called what we can call as this is a CAR data set, the earlier one. The second one we used something called a bank data set, just to say yes or no. And third one is IRIS data set to say the multi-level classification. So all the three things use case of how to use neural network using R. So I hope this is clear. If you have any doubt, we have another 5 minutes time. I am glad to explain to you. I hope this session, I just want to give more importance for this because your director is very particular about a neural network. But see that every technique has got its own plus and minus. Like how everything has got own and plus and minus. Okay, just a minute. Hello.
Sir, we have understood whatever you have said, sir.
Just a minute. Yes, Chirag, just a minute. Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. Regarding? Okay, please call me after 10 o'clock.
Sir, what should I do?
Call later? Yeah, sure. Okay, yes, Chirag, sorry. I got some calling.
Sir, we have understood whatever you have conveyed.
Okay. So, yeah, you can give your feedback to your coordinator if you don't want to give negative feedback on the page. No problem, you can give back to your ready or Priyaj. Okay, so I finished a third model. So this is our last class. Okay, not only neural network, if you have any other doubt on the old thing, you can clarify. Yeah, still we have five more minutes. And if you feel that no, you are very clear and you know everything, you understand everything 100% and you are in position to reproduce it in the examination, then I have no concern. Then we can call for a day also. Okay, anyway, wait for 2 more minutes. You decide and you can come. So okay, Chirag, if there is no doubt, shall I close the session?
I hope so, sir. There is no doubt, I guess.
Okay. Thank you so much for your time. Okay, see you then.
Thank you, sir.